Up till now, we've covered a great deal of complex settings on the LASAF software. This can be a little overwhelming, but we've prepared a quick start guide for you to use when you come to the laboratory. It's a whole menu of all the functions that we've shown you today. You can take this home with you and study it and bring it back when you work with the microscope. Now let's talk about shutdown of the entire system. Now that we've completed our session for the day, we want to shut down the software and the system in a proper fashion. To do that, we go back to our configuration tab and we turn off each of the lasers that are on the configuration menu. Once those are done, we can go back to our acquire tab. Now that the lasers have been powered down, we can exit LASAF by clicking on the red box, and it asks me, do I wish to save my experiment? Since we already saved it, I won't save it again, but this is a last opportunity to save all my images and work before I shut down completely. So I'll say no, and the system automatically shuts down and goes back to Windows. Now that I'm at my Windows screen, I can turn off Windows, and the system will exit Windows. And then I can check my microscope to make sure it's completely shut down. We rock our illuminator out of the way. We take our slide off the stage. We dial our objective back down to the empty space. Bring our illuminator back into place. And now we're ready to shut down the power buttons. Do not forget to turn the power off on the reflected light epi illuminator for the microscope. The power down sequence for the microscope and the computer is as follows. Turn off the laser key. Skip the laser power button and turn off the scanner and the PC and the microscope. After 15 minutes, you can turn off the fan that's now cooling the lasers. We're now ending this chapter with some images taken by James Goh and Ray Hong of a favorite species of nematode. It's green because it is expressing green fluorescent protein, which is actually reporting on the promoter from a gene of interest. It is expressed in the cells of the excretory system. This is a maximum projection of multiple still images. Notice the two faint GFP expressing canals on the right, as well as the fine ducts on the left. These structures were not visible using a standard epifluorescent microscope. Now we move on to a video of the worm. This is the head of the round worm, and we're looking at neuronal sheath cells. Thank you for your participation in these training videos. This is Mark Armitage signing off from the Microscopy Laboratory in the Biology Department of California State University, Northridge. We want to thank Brian Smith, our videographer and video editor, and also the Keck Foundation for their wonderful support, which not only paid for these videos, but for the microscope that you're learning. Thanks again.